Dave Cathy, the Food Dude, and I'm back here at American Propane for Open Flame 2013. We're back and we're better than ever. We're gonna be working on Primo smokers today. It's May, that's National Barbecue Month. It's time to get the grills dusted off and see what you can do. We've got a lot to learn today about classic barbecue with a few surprises. So sit back and enjoy Open Flame. I'm here with American Propane owner Jim Grigsby. Jim, it's been a while since we've been out here. What have you been up to?
Oh, not much. Just kind of sitting back, cashing in my coupons. No, we're here at our brand new store, unveiling it tonight for the first time in 13 months.
Pretty exciting stuff. I mean, the old place was a nice place, but this is kind of the Taj Mahal for barbecue. Tell me about it.
We're really proud. We moved into a building 9 years ago that was an existing building and had an unfortunate accident here and had an opportunity to rebuild. We thought about it for a while, and I said, we've been here for 80 years, we've got to rebuild, and I think we've put something in Oklahoma City that's not available at this point until now, and this is our first night to unveil it.
Well, it's pretty exciting stuff. Got a good crowd filing in, so let's go have some fun. What do you say?
Let's do it.
Hi, my name is Patty Hamby. I'm a chef. I'm from Peru. I work in a gourmet grill, Buy For Less, wonderful company. Tonight, I'm making a scallops wrapped with a ribeye steak, and I choose ribeye steak because it's a wonderful steak and tender. I finish it up with a chimichurri sauce. This chimichurri sauce is a wonderful sauce, make it with a lot of herbs and olive oil, and get the finish and the juicy flavor with the beef and the scallops.
Hi, I'm Russ Garrett, the original Smokin' Okie, and in tonight's classes, I'll be teaching everybody how to do brisket and burn-ins. We'll start with the process of how to select the brisket, use choice or better quality beef. From that, we'll talk about trimming. I'm a minimalist on trimming, so I like to leave a lot of fat on there, but there is some fat that you'll want to trim off. Then we season it. I don't season the fat side, we'll season the meat side. Put it on the smoker. Typically, you'll shoot for a 200 to 250 degree temperature, and then you want to shoot for a finishing temp somewhere around 190 to 200. At that point, you need to test the brisket to see if it's tender. You can't always shoot for just an exact temperature. Every cow's different, so every temperature is going to vary a little bit. And in the end, what you have is a piece of brisket. If you've done it right, it looks like a meteorite. That's a good thing. It's not burnt, it's a cooked brisket. At that point, we separate the point from the flat. The flat is the typical section where you get slices. The point is the fatty part, or it just has more fat than the others. We separate that, cube that up, reseason sauce, put that in the smoker, couple of hours comes out, and we have what we know as barbecue crack. We have the brisket burn-ins. Real popular at our restaurant. You know, it's becoming something much more well-known in Oklahoma.
Hi there, my name is Amy Gillert. I'm the sous chef with Mutt's Amazing Hot Dogs and Big Truck Tacos. And tonight we are here to introduce one of our recipes we're going to be using at our new restaurant, Backdoor Barbecue. We have a slow-smoked short rib. It's hickory smoked. We've got a nice chili rub on there. And we're also featuring our espresso barbecue sauce. It's one of the sauces we'll be featuring at our new restaurant. Kind of your basic ketchup, vinegar, some chili powder in there, and some coffee, which is one of the main ingredients. Different, but really good. And then we're also featuring our potato salad, so Yukon Gold potato salad with some red onions and bacon and cilantro in there. We slow smoked our short ribs for 4 hours with the hickory smoke and get them real nice and tender, and you get a char on the outside. It's delicious, and with the espresso sauce, it really ties it all in together.
All right, well, I'm stepping aside from the grill today a little bit. We got a lot of people know what they're doing with barbecue. I can do some barbecue myself, but I wanted to just manage the sides today. So I've got some ranch style beans, just like we make down in Texas where I grew up. Sorry, no baked beans here. Baked beans are for hamburgers where I'm from. I love them, but I did ranch style beans for this barbecue. Other thing I did is a smoked cheese and macaroni salad. Yeah, the macaroni salad that we all love. I couldn't resist doing a little bit with the Primo. So we smoked off some mild cheddar cheese, threw that in there. All right, that's it for this month's Open Flame. We're going to be doing these for the rest of the summer and the early part of the fall. Check us out, newsok.com. We'll have details on when the next Open Flame will occur. recipes. If you're looking for recipes from tonight's show, we're going to have those also on newsok.com. Check those out, try them out, and let us know what you think. Thanks for watching. Open Flame.